You'll remember we started referring to variants by their geography, but then in May, the WHO renamed them all to try to avoid stigmatising those countries. So that's now why we have, of course, Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta, etc., as you see on this chart from covariants.org. A little confusingly, but if we follow this Greek alphabet naming system, then this new variant, B11529, would actually be called the new variant, NU, that is. But when visualising variants, it's always important to remember they are constantly evolving in scope and size. Now, this is from nextstrain.org, which sounds a little ominous. It's a global picture of the variants over the course of the pandemic. Now, all of these ones that you see, I'm going to circle them here, the greens and blues here, those are all Delta on their own, officially three Delta strains. Easily it is the most prevalent and long-lasting. Now, I'll just get rid of those and we'll go a little further down and you will see these other blue and purple ones. Gamma is there, Alpha is there, and Beta is there. They've sort of petered out. But then we have 21K here, this little red dot, which is our new variant. That's the global view. But if we switch to an Africa focus, you see here, same red dot, it's a bit bigger, it's growing, and as some are saying, it is potentially the worst so far. Scientists say it has around 30 different mutations, which is twice as many as the Delta variant had.